Welcome to Connie Martinson Talks Books. So you want to be an actor, or better still, you've been cast in a role in your local theater. Well, do you know what to do? Do you know how to focus your eyes, or even just plain focus? Well, my guest today, Joanne Linville, who is known for being one of the better theater coaches, has written Seven Steps to an Acting Craft, and it is co-authored with John Deck. Welcome, Joanne.
Thank you very much for having me, Connie.
It is my pleasure and honor, truly, Joanne.
Oh, thank you.
So let's start with, somebody walks into your class and they stand up, and what is the first thing you ask them about, which is inner life?
I get them in a half circle. And I say, I want you all to go into your inner life. You know what your inner life is? Are you acquainted with it? Do you know how often you're in it? We're in it and out it, out here in the now, and we go into another place, which is our inner life.
And they look at you with the blank eyes and say, what the heck is she talking about?
So they will see me go into mine.
What you're doing now.
Yeah. So they see that. And then they try to do it. They try to get there. So John explains it so brilliantly, how he puts down how you go in and out. And he catches the reader by making them that actor or that person mm-hmm. reading the book. Suddenly he turns it on you, and you remember something which takes you out of your focus. Well, these seven steps are all what every great actor does.
Now, you also say focus, and I thought that was an interesting word to use, because the eyes will tell you if you're
focused.
Everything, focus.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. And they will tell you when you're not. And you'll sit in an audition room, and there'll be a lot of actors sitting around, and we go in and out of our life. We just hear where is the person who's going to call our name. And then I look at you, and I see your beautiful jewelry and things. And then I get back here into myself. What was I going to do for lunch? Should I call so-and-so? Yeah. Then my eyes bring me out into this now.
But I loved your story of how you ended up being trying out for the Actors Studio. It wasn't your audition, it was the person with you, Robert Loggia.
That's right. And I said, there was a very, very bright businesswoman who lived next door to me. And I was wondering whether to go in there with pajamas, and because it was a morning fight. It was a room upstairs, which was a very famous French.
Uh-huh.
And he took it, Robert wrote it from the book. But she said, don't go in with pajamas and no makeup in the morning and the truth. Go in there like a million bucks, look like a million bucks, and easy and free. And I did. And so they invited me in, Kazan and Lee Strasberg and Cheryl Crawford. Big.
Now, that applies, too, to the third. I'm going to be going through the seventh. Tenses. Because you could have played it in the past. You could have played it present.
No, you'd play one sentence.
Yeah.
And have the beginning is in the now. You know, I want to tell you, Connie, something about when I was in school in Long Beach, and then I come back into the now, which was a long time ago.
Yeah.
But then I go back to get it. See, there's the past. Now, when you don't speak English well, or you don't speak Spanish like I don't speak, I can only speak it in the present tense.
Yeah.
People who don't speak good English only speak in the present tense.
Uh-huh.
There's no conjugating the verbs,
they
say. I don't know what that means.
It means he says, she says,
right.
I say
you. I said it yesterday, and I will say it again tomorrow. Well, those are two places, you mm-hmm. see. So you switch, when you're talking, you'll go from the now to the present now, to the past, to the future, back to the now, back to the, We can do it like this, like nothing.
But difficult for the actor on a stage who's playing a part if the part is not part of them.
Bologna sauce.
Yeah.
See, I think acting is more the body than the head. The head gets us in trouble. The head's going to say, you're not doing that very well. Look how your hand is shaking, huh? Your brain, you can't make your brain think the way you want it to think. You've got to be fed. You've got to be fed by the place. Not that there's a fireplace here and a window there.
Mm-hmm.
No. But Hamlet, who makes his shoes, his velvet slippers?
Mm-hmm.
He loves her. She loves him. She measures your foot. Look how your foot, Hamlet, is growing. You're becoming a man. Huh? That's going to give me Hamlet.
Yeah.
What I've got on my feet.
Joanne, when you were acting, you were telling me you're trained with Stella Adler.
Very, very much trained with Stella. And Anjana enters.
Uh-huh.
I have to mention Anjana. She's very important. I don't think in this first thing she is spoken of enough, if at all.
Mm-hmm.
I have to have Anjana because Anjana gave me the body about the eyes, about how eyes must feed you. Your imagination puts it there.
Yeah.
But it has to feed you. You can't feed your emotions. You can't feed because it won't work. It won't work. It'll work one or two times to deal with my father. But it won't work the fourth time. It won't work the fifth time.
Yeah. How then would you play with somebody who came from the actor's studio training?
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm in the actor's studio.
Yeah.
I go there, huh? I have a lot of people come to me for poetry and Shakespeare, you know?
Yeah.
And when I get to experiencing the word, they get all nutty about it because they don't think people speak like that. Well, we don't speak like the Elizabethans. But there's music and poetry in Shakespeare. You have to have the tempo of that character.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you have to use every word.
But
because the
but they're talking about using emotional memory.
I know.
Yeah.
Baloney. Like I said, it'll work a few times for you. But one day, I'm in the dressing room trying to get tears. Where are the tears? I could dry every part. I had tears, tears, tears. Huh? Suddenly, I'm with Leo Penn, and the first shot is me crying over something that I'm supposed to feel badly about, but I killed him. So how am I can't get any tears about it. I can't get anything.
Onions.
I am praying.
Raw onions. Using
I said I'll quit acting if I have to ever use anything to get a tear.
Yeah.
What happened? I let myself go. I said, all right. Yeah, I can't get a tear. I'm on my knees. I swear to God, I was on my knees. I got in front of the camera. Here's the camera right in front of me like this. And the got with the
click. Yeah.
Old man, I looked into his eyes and I burst into tears. Mm. Huh? You have to let it. You have to have it. You can't feed it.
Yeah.
See, I was trying to feed it in there, trying to get it. No, you got to be fed. You got to, and that is icing on the cake.
Mm-hmm.
The other is playing the violin. You damn well can't go down and say, you know, I'm a violinist. I want to be in the Philharmonic.
Yeah.
No, you gotta practice a long time. Takes a long time to be a real actor.
Yeah.
Anthony Hopkins, his eyes, watch his eyes.
Yeah.
Listen to Frank Sinatra's tenses.
Yeah.
John Deck is a wonderful, wonderful writer, don't you think?
Yes, yes. I assumed you had written it, but assume the two of you.
No, it's my technique.
Uh-huh.
But John wrote it.
Yeah.
And he's my cousin.
Ah.
And he won the best short story of the year in Atlantic Monthly. And he's been published, and he's been in Esquire, and he's...
Yeah.
For him to do this for me, I, you know, because I had to give him this.
You had to give him the food in order to have the product.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
So they can, you know, they can go to Amazon, they can go to...
The word props.
JoanneLinville.com.
Yeah. Hmm? Yeah. Joanne.
Yes.
Place.
Place
and props.
See, John says the great thing. After working on it, he said, the place is almost like a prop.
Mm-hmm.
It is a prop.
Yeah.
So the place is everything. How you behave in an intensive care unit, your eyes look around and you see something you wish you hadn't seen later because it doesn't get out of your mind, huh? And you whisper, you're not going to laugh.
Mm-hmm.
But you get to a ball game, the place gives you.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah. I must say, I saw Al Pacino's Richard III.
Yes.
Brilliant. For me, it was a brilliant film.
Well, I have a thing. He is brilliant.
Yeah.
His Dr. Kevorkian blew me away.
Yeah.
Blew me away. But I've always, I want to talk to him because I don't know whether he's gotten that thing with experiencing the word yet.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe he has. I haven't seen it yet.
Yeah. What have
to
you...
To what I...
Yeah, Joanne,
how
also...
How dare I, you know.
People watching will say, I know I've seen her in X, Y, and Z.
Yeah.
What have you been playing lately?
I haven't.
Yeah.
No, because my thing has happened in the classroom. You know who Alvin Sargent is?
Of course.
Of course. Alvin Sargent, the great writer of Paper Moon and Julia. And he said to me, you should be teaching, Joanne. And I was in my 30s, I think. And I said, oh, what am I going to do? Put up a sign? No, he said, go over to Oakwood at my son's school and start there, which I did.
Uh-huh.
Hmm. And then I got the idea of Stella coming and we would do a video of Stella.
Yeah.
Well, it didn't turn into a video. It turned into a school. She gave us that and we brought her and built her a theater and gave her everything. It was all for Stella.
Was she that magical?
All magical. Yeah. Nobody, first of all, was as smart.
Mm-hmm.
No woman, man on earth was any smarter than Stella.
Yeah.
She would put her feet in ice water to stay awake, to read in the, you know? She was, Columbia University asked her to break down Goethe's Faust.
Yeah.
Huh? She was much smarter than Harold Clurman.
Yeah.
But Harold got all the stuff.
Yeah.
But Stella was 5'10". Probably was 6 foot and didn't want to admit it.
I did not know she was that tall.
And
because
she had blonde hair,
Jacob
the most
Adler.
Gorgeous hair when she was 90. I would comb her hair. Beautiful thing. Chest up, beautiful breasts.
Yeah.
That she was constantly kind of showing.